Moses, righteousness be restored. And the elite of the the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, building a temple of praise. Yeah. And these are the days of the harvest. Fields are as wide in the world. Come on. You are coming soon. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. There's no God like Jehovah. 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 Yes, Lord. Come on. He comes riding on a cloud, shining like the sun at the trumpet call. In the year of Jubilee, behold, he comes riding on a cloud, shining like the sun at the trumpet call. Hallelujah! Come on! Ura basanda, ra basanda, ra bakara basunda, ra basanda. Behold, he comes riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. Yeah, lift your voice in the year of Jubilee, Jesus. Hallelujah. Riding on the cloud. Hallelujah. Come on. The year of Jubilee. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, Jesus. Come on, come on, patient comes. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Behold, he
on a cloud, shining like the sun at the trumpet call. Lift your voice.
Praise God. Leon.
Hello. Great song. It's in with the message tonight, huh? Oh, is it, I think,
I was a bit scared of that. Yeah.
The only comes riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. It's in with the message tonight, praise God. Oh. Hallelujah. Well, it's good to be with you tonight. I'd like to welcome everyone who'll be tuning in live on the broadcast and on the videos. And I've said before, please share these videos if you know how to share it. Very simple. You watch the video and you see a thing called share. And what you do, you take your finger and you press it and you share it. That's how you share it. You've got a lesson how to share it. But the more you share it, how many friends you have on Facebook? I only have two, so it's easy. But the more friends you have on Facebook, just share it. And you are reaching out to people, maybe some who don't know Jesus Christ, and you're sending that video out, and they're hearing the Word of God. So the more we can share it, the better. We don't get a penny for this, but we can spread the Word, and people can hear the Word. So we've got a very simple message tonight. And we meet here as well every Sunday. 5:15 is the new time. 5:15, winter's coming, the dark nights are coming, so we're starting a bit early. So 5:15, every Sunday at Norley Hall Community Centre. This is the CLMI Apostolic Church, and we're here to reach out to every home in this area. So let's just pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, you see the desires of our hearts. And Lord, when you first told me to start a church in this place, you showed me a vision of you on the cross in the middle of this estate here in Orley Hall. I saw you on the cross in the middle of the estate, and you said, plant a church here. Because you said that you died for every single person in this area. And the entire world you died for. So that's why we planted it here. Father, we pray for every home in this area. In Norley Hall, Worsley Hall, Kick Green and Marsh Green. We pray for every man, woman and child in their homes tonight. And we ask, Lord, for those who are living in darkness, that they will come to know you, the light of the world. That Jesus, that they will have an encounter with you that will turn their lives completely around. And that they will receive you, and in receiving you, they will receive forgiveness of sins. They will receive your Holy Spirit. And they will receive the gift of eternal life. So Lord, we pray for every home, every week in this area, that they will have a visitation of you, Jesus Christ, and that we will be drawn into this place where we can make disciples. Because you said, go into all the world and make disciples. So Lord, we ask that you would draw the people in. Father, you said that no one can come to you unless the Father draws them. So, Father, we ask that you would draw people to faith in your Son, Jesus Christ, to faith in you, and that their lives may be turned around. Father, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Well, I forgot my glasses again. Hallelujah. But I think I can make it out. The title of the message tonight, although it looked, 3:20 this afternoon, and it's time to get serious with God. It's time to get serious with God. Why? Because Jesus is coming sooner than we think. Me and James were talking outside just about, James was saying they've rebuilt the temple in Israel, and they've even started doing the animal sacrifices. And it all fits in with the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. So it fits in with this message tonight as well, because that's what this message is about. And it's found in 2 Peter's Gospel,
2 Peter's Gospel, chapter 3, and we're going to be going through it. And for anybody who watches the news this week, I think it was on Friday, all over the world, there was a big protest demonstration for global change. Schools was allowed out to schools, and schools all over the world, in every nation, were protesting in London, Manchester, demanding a change to come to stop this global warming. They're trying to save the earth. All over, it's gone global. This 16-year-old girl started it, and it's gone global all over the world. And my question would be to them, what do you think of Jesus Christ? Hallelujah. And it'd be very interesting to see what answer you would get. I bet he's not even in the equation. It's man again trying to fix things by their own time. And we're going to be reading it very shortly in here. And the Bible says that the earth is reserved for fire. And God's going to consume this earth with fire at the end of time. Mm. He says it consumes the earth, and it's just like in the days of Noah, God judged the earth with the flood, but this time its judgment is going to come with fire. So I'm glad I'm not investing in a mansion or a log cabin, because you'll get burnt up. I'm glad I don't have a Bentley, because it's going to get burnt up. Everything is reserved for fire. But we see people in this whole society, this whole world, is fixed on people achieving success to build their future, and success is determined in what you have. How sad is that? That's what this whole society is built on. And you know what? Jesus said everything in this earth is going to perish, the Bible says. He says, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word, this word, this is what we should be invested in, the word of God. It's never going to pass away. It's never going to perish. The kingdom of God, we should be putting all our time into the work of the kingdom of God, because that's going to last for all eternity. But the devil, he wants to trap us into this whole mentality of building our lives here on earth for what we can get, what we can accumulate. Jesus is not interested in any of that. Mm. He's not interested in any of it. And sad to say, in the Western church, it's creeped in, and it's full of it, the Western church. Full of it. There's a pastor in Africa, the millionaire pastor, they call him. He turns up in his limousine. He has bodyguards with him. He has his own perfume collection with his name on it. And they worship him as though he's a god. How deceived can people be? So if you see me turning up like that, it's just firemen. So anyway, let's get the word of God. Now, don't get me wrong. I mean, we are called to be stewards of the earth. God said when he put Adam and Eve in the garden, he told Adam to take care of the garden and that. So we do have a responsibility to be good stewards of what we have. But let's bear in mind that all will be burnt up in the end time. So in 2 Peter's Gospel, chapter 3, and it's entitled, The Day of the Lord. Now Peter is writing this letter to the early church in that day where he was preaching this message, and he wrote this letter to the church. Bear in mind, they was expecting the return of the Lord Jesus Christ in their day. Mm. They really thought he was going to come back in their generation. And every generation of Christians have believed that ever since. So we too, we must expect the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. He will come again. And you can look all around the world. And in Matthew 24:25, it tells us that the things to look for that mark the signs of his return again. Jesus is going to come back very soon. And when you read Matthew 24:25, it's all happening. And that is very significant they're doing the animal sacrifice. That tells me we are crossing them within. Once they've started, I didn't know they were doing that, but that tells me it's very significant now. So time is running short. Time is to get serious with God. And so Peter wrote this letter to the early church, and he said, "Dear friends, this is now my second letter to you." And it gets us off track. It gets us off track. It might be good music, but it gets us off track. And so we need to guard ourselves on a daily basis. So it's to produce wholesome thinking. I want you to recall the words spoken in the past by the holy prophets and the commands given by our Lord and our Saviour through your apostles. First of all, you must understand that in the last days, scoffers will come. Scoffing and following their own evil desires. How do you know someone who is a scoffer? They follow their own evil desires. You know, we see it. When you go on the streets, you're surrounded with scoffers. Soon as you walk on that street in Blackpool, London, Manchester, where, soon as you walk on the street and you start proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ, guess what comes out of the woodwork? The scoffers. You're surrounded with scoffers. Why? Why do they not want Jesus Christ? Because Jesus Christ demands change. And they don't want change in their life. They won't go out there drunk every night. That's why they reject Jesus, because Jesus demands change. When I came to Christ, he demanded that I had to stop stealing. I had to stop getting drunk. I had to stop being involved in pornography. When Jesus Christ came into my life, all these things had to stop. He said, "This stops now. If you're following me, this stops. If you don't want to follow me, go back into it." You know, and many of my friends left me because they said, "We don't like the new Des. You're a Bible basher." I said, "Well, so bye." But praise God, Jesus Christ demands change, and he's the one who brings that change in us. You know, we can't change ourselves. The harder we try to change ourselves, that we realize the more we fall. Because God has to work that change within us. He gives us the power to change. See, all this demonstration, what's going on in the earth, they're trying by their own power to bring change in the world. And the house of God. And he said, "My house shall be called a house of prayer." I bet many thought, a God of love, because it was the righteous anger that stirred Jesus. They've turned my house into a business. Listen, church, if your church is a business for profit, it's time to repent and make it what it should be, a house of prayer. So it says that it's reserved for fire, being kept for the day of judgment and the destruction of unbelief. The Lord is not slow in keeping his promises. He is patient with you. Why is he slow? Why is he's not brought this fire yet? Because he is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. That's why we've not seen God destroy everything yet, because God wants as many people to come to faith in him before the end time. That's why he's slow. He says God is faithful to as many people as possible. You know, nobody knows the date of their death. People think they're living forever. But there's a time coming when their heart will stop and they will find themselves stood before Almighty God on the day of judgment. And they will have no chance then. That's why we need to tell people as many as possible the gospel of Jesus Christ. It says here, but the day of the Lord will come like a thief. It will come like a thief. How many knows when a thief is coming to their house? You don't, do you? We've been broken three times. Three times. Twice we was in the house. Upstairs. It says, that day will bring about the destructions of the heavens by fire, and the elements will melt in the heat. But in keeping his promise, we are looking forward to a new heaven and a new earth, the home of the righteous. So then, dear friends, since you are looking forward to this, make every effort to be found spotless and at peace with God. Bear in mind that our Lord's patience means salvation. Just as our dear brother Paul